Holy, it's over, guys. It's oh my god, oh my god, it's actually over for everyone. Chip is now on top. He is going to reign supreme, and I'm just happy to be here, guys. I'm happy to be here. Nago's done. Now the matchup is fine, because the problem before was I had nothing against 2S. There's nothing Chip could do against 2S. Now that mother whiffs that shit, I'm in that ass. It's over. So let's look at these notes, bro. Creator, the Geo buffs, bro. Geo's gonna be looking kind of nasty, dude. Geo's kind of looking good, bro. Let's look through this shit, dude. Okay. What else? Okay, so cross-platform. While this is on, online match, blah, blah, blah. Oh, you could choose. Wow. Okay, so you could fucking choose to have cross-platform play on or off. Wow. Okay. I feel like that's a very fair compromise. Because a lot of people were like, I don't want to play PlayStation bums. So that's a fair compromise. I like that. Choice is good. Platform icon next to player names. Connection indicator. No more Wi-Fi warriors getting away with murder. No more Wi-Fi warriors getting away with murder. Added a mute function which hides the player name and any text sent by the specific player on your screen. That's fine. Though I never use the in-game communication. Ever. I don't even know, like, how that even works. Do you know what I'm saying? Fix a bug. Rank tower. Adjusted rules for assigned floor changes. What does this mean? To make it easier to match with players at the same skill level, the rule preventing players from falling below after repeated losses has been eased. Okay. I thought that's already how it worked. I don't even know. Oh, you could continue to rematch up to 3 matches. Okay, that's fine. Fixed a bug where the processing load would increase when a counter hit. Oh yeah, that happens. This happens. You know, that fucking happens. When you hit counter hit and that shit starts lagging, that's happened. All right, universal mechanics. This is the juice. This is what everybody wants to read anyway. Okay, overall, I'm excited for everything, but the changes were not significant. Let's just get that out of the, you know, right out the box. The changes were minor. They were minor changes for everyone. Okay? Minor changes for everyone. Okay, so changes to game mechanics. These changes address the issue of the difficulty for the defender to launch a counteroffensive. Remaining. Now increases more the higher your character's risk level. This is a great change. I like this because, like, let's say you choose right and you DP. Or you mash at the right moment or whatever. If your risk was cranked, your attention gauge is going to increase. This makes it so that you can make comebacks a little easier. So it's like a minor comeback mechanic that they added. That's pretty good. And it also rewards like IBFD use and it rewards things. So I kind of like that change overall. Oh, the attacker's tension gauge would increase more and more. Okay, I think this gets rid of Chip's positive bonus infinite. I'm pretty sure. Is that what that sounds like, guys? That's like what it sounds like to me. You know, I can't keep building bar when their risk level is max, so I have to force a mix up. I don't see this as like a crazy big change, to be honest. You know, the positive bonus infinite is still in, but now I don't build tension if the risk is all the way up. I like the positive bonus infinites, but I get that everybody else doesn't. I only like them because I play Chip. I get it. That shit was gangster. The rate of risk level depletion over time is now faster. Okay, that's good. That's actually really good. That means that basically if you escape offense, kind of the same thing. If you manage to get out of a bad situation and your risk was cranked, your risk goes all the way down. This lowers damage overall. So this is really good. Risk level now resets when Psych Burst is activated. I never even noticed that risk level wouldn't reset when you bursted. But yeah, that makes total sense. Why the fuck wouldn't that doesn't make sense that it wasn't like that always. But okay, that's a good change. Okay, so the height of the hurt box as the attack comes out is now the same for all characters. The height of the hurt box was the same for all characters at the lowest point of the attack, but the hurt box height during startup varied between characters. That's true. That's actually true. The thing is about 6P is that in the current version of the game, there's two different kinds of 6Ps. There's some 6Ps that have invul between like the upper body, and then some that have it in the lower body. And then just the properties of the 6Ps vary between characters. Like Chip's 6P worked a lot different than Ram's 6P. So I'm not exactly sure what this is going to entail to, but it could be worse or it could be better. You know, I think Chip's 6P was not good. So the fact that the height of the hurtbox is now the same for all characters. I mean, I think that's probably good. I think this is probably a good thing overall. I don't know if it's going to be better or worse for most characters. Who knows? But the hurtbox height, making the height of the hurtbox as the attack comes out the same. Yeah, this could be a nerf for Chip. Because you know how Chip, his JH just blows up a lot of 6Ps? Now I think that, like, I think it's either that most characters are going to be able to 6P Chip, like, no problem. Or that it's going to be worse and he's going to be able to jump in on some characters for, like, everyone for free. You know what I'm saying? So, I think this could potentially be a nerf for Chip. But a minor nerf. Okay, base damage scaling has been added for attacks that did not have it previously, with the exception of certain moves. I think this is overall a buff for Chip, because that means that he's not going to die as often from, like, every hit. Do you know what I'm saying? This means that I have more chances to outplay you. Base damage scaling? That's huge. Bro, that's huge. That's a buff for Chip. A buff for a lot of the lower health characters, and a buff for everyone that just wants to outplay. You know what I'm saying? It kind of sucked being like one shot. Tension gauge, increase the amount of tension gained when blocking attacks. The amount gained now increases more depending on your character's risk level. That's a great change. Oh my god. That's great. That means that you're going to have more meter available for like YRCs and things like that. Because one of the big complaints is that like when you were on defense, when you were blocking, like let's say you're just blocking Chip over and over again, you're not building a lot of bar, but I was building a fuck ton of bar. I was just running that offense, fucking hitting your ass, close slash 2S, dash up close slash, gamma blade 2S, fucking whatever, right? I'm building a fuck ton of bar and you're not building much. Yeah, so it makes FD cheaper in a net way. Very huge. Good point, creator. This gives you more attention to FD and IBFD with. And this is a net nerf for Happy Chaos, for example. You don't have fucking meter for shit against that motherfucker. So this is good. Okay, risk level. Increased rate of risk level depletion over time. I like all the changes to risk so far. That's really good. Roman cancel is now the same when performed with attack buttons and with the Roman cancel button. Oh, shit. This nerfed. Oh, this is a nerf for Chip. This is a nerf for Chip. Chip had a bug where I could use the Roman cancel button instead of using the manual RC buttons. And basically, I would get free activation from Senshu. So like on a Senshu, that's Rekka 3, on his overhead, if I use the RC, if it counter hit, the meter wouldn't be used. Do you know what I'm saying? If I use the RC button. If I use the actual 3 buttons or whatever you would use to RC, he would RC every time. So it kind of option selected that. So they fixed that, so that's no longer going to be a thing. That sucks for Chip, but I don't think he's going to need it anymore. The height of the hurt box as the attack comes out is now the same for all characters. This is ambiguous. Is the height of the hurt box bigger or is it lower? Do you know what I'm saying? Is it bigger or is it lower? I don't know. I don't know what this means. It could be fucking worse. But I would like it so that everybody gets to anti-air a little bit better. Okay, with the exception of certain moves such as close standing S, added base damage scaling for attacks that did not have it previously. Yeah, that's good. We have to think about what this means. Which attacks did not have base damage scaling? Do you know what I'm saying? To me, that sounds like Leo DP. This sounds like, you know, things like that. You know? This could be a nerf for Chip. Could be a nerf for Chip. 6K could be nerfed. Rekka 3 could be nerfed. That might be why they're giving Chip a lot of new shit. Who knows? Who knows what it's gonna, you know? I don't know. But lowering damage is I think, a good thing. This means that the better player has a better chance of outplaying you more and more. If damage is lower over and over again. You know? That means, you know, less robbery potential. That's good. Okay, attack level. So attack level, yeah. Character strength, with some exceptions. P and K attacks have a low attack level, whereas H and special moves tend to have high attack level. Proximity requirement for attack to connect. Yeah, so you can see the present scale. Before, he would hit over here, and then he would get hit. Now, you see his arms extending? It doesn't hit until it's closer. This is a buff for Ino, for example, in this case, because now it hits exactly when you want it to hit. Do you know what I mean? We'd have to see what examples of this there are. But that's probably a buff for a lot of characters. A buff for Ino, as you can see here. Etc. Okay, this is the juice now. Now we're getting to the juice. Okay. All right, Soul Bad Guy. The extended range of standing HS makes his offense using far standing S even more potent. I guess so. Expanded frontal hitbox. That means that you could connect from it from a further range. While it is now more challenging for him to get huge rewards from mid range, the changes to Gunflame make him better at poking from mid range. Decreased attack startup, decreased active frames. Increased movement speed of projectile. This likely means that you can no longer FD his strings and then jump at him with Gunflame. This means that Gunflame potentially could be a safe ender for his block strings. That's a buff for him. Decreased attack level on forward S. Oh, that's what they mean about attack level. So like attack level on forward S, that's the the wide spreading move. The damage that he could get from that was reduced. And it not also no longer launches the opponent on grounded counter hit. This is a nerf. He got a nerf. Forward S is nerfed. Standing HS, expanded frontal hitbox. I mean, that's a buff. But this is a nerf. And then this is a buff. So he got two buffs and a nerf. I think that's overall he might be better. I don't know. Hard to say. Okay, let's look at Kai. The addition of the Guard Crush effect to Sacred Edge during Shock State and Dragon Install allows him to maintain his offense regardless of range. Standing S, expanded frontal hitbox. That's good. That means you can hit with that move further. That's a good, that's a buff. Fudra Arc, decreased knockback on hit. Potentially a nerf, but also a buff, both. Oh, it's only on hit, not on block. Okay, that's good. What do you guys think? Fudra Arc, decreased knockback on hit? I don't know. Yeah, I guess it makes it easier to continue his offense. That might mean that he gets better combos from Fudra Arc. Hard to say, like how much of a difference that is. Added Guard Crush effect to the final hit? Sacred Edge during Shock State. Added Guard Crush effect. Wow. That's cool. Okay. Sacred Edge during Dragon Install. Damn, added Guard. That's cool. I think that's interesting. Right? That means that you could set up some cute stuff with Sacred Edge now. I think that's fine. That's great for Kai. This is Kai buff. Kai looking more buffed. He didn't get any nerfs. Right? This is all good. This is great for Kai. Guard Crush effect? That's pretty fucking awesome. That means that shit is plus as fuck. And now you could probably do some shit where you could do dash 2K or 5D. Who knows? Who knows how that works? I don't know how that's gonna work. But what sucks is that it's locked behind meter. So that sucks. But overall, he looks like he got some juice. All right, May, horizontal dolphin has less recovery now when it connects with the opponent. Ooh, this makes S version less risky and HS version more plus, making both more viable than before. Four Face is happy about this. That motherfucker loves dolphin. What the fuck? So S version being less risky, HS version being more plus, that's fucking great for May players. That's scary. The extra distance for her forward jump also makes her aerial approaches more potent. That's fucking nuts. Okay, so her slide, reduce recovery, increase active frames. Fuck. Increase movement distance from her forward jump. Oh my god. Jumping down H now triggers counter effect. What the fuck? Okay, she got buffs literally everywhere. They were like, you know what? There's not enough May players. We'll just make her broken. Okay. May is fucking good. She got juiced. Okay, Axel. Oh my god. He has a list of changes. Yeah, that's actually crazy. But whatever. We're just gonna have to hold that. Axel, the ability to cancel standing P, crouching P, and other pokes during their recovery on hit or block makes his strengths more prominent at his preferred range. Rainwater now draws the opponent in, increasing the reward on hit and making it possible for Axel to maintain his offense on block. Wow. That's pretty good. Fuck, man. This means that Remy's gonna be even harder to beat now. Fuck, man. Damn it, Remy. God damn it. All right. Standing P cannot be special canceled on hit or block. Crouch P cannot be special canceled. That's all really good. Standing heavy, the opponent will now be in a crouching state on grounded counter hit. That introduces new combo opportunities. Winter Mantis. Adjusted blowback when used as part of a combo. Now launches opponent higher with increased horizontal blowback, added tumble effect. Wow. Okay. That's pretty fucking good. Tumble effect? God damn, you're gonna be fucking hitting people and making them roll like I hit you with a 5H. Increased knockback from snail. That's pretty good. Rainwater, yeah, this is good. Axel got buffed. That doesn't need to be said. He got buffed. He got a lot of good changes. I don't know how that's gonna happen, but Axel's looking fucking nasty, dude. Now nobody's gonna be able to beat Remy. This is fucked up, because Remy puts in work with shitty ass Axel. All right, this is crazy. Okay, all right, here we go. Chip, baby. Chip, okay. Alpha Blade horizontal now sends the opponent flying towards Chip, making it easier to land more hits. Currently, the P Alpha is not really used at all. You don't use P Alpha. P Alpha is used, I use it after like Gamma Blade counter hit, and then I do a dash up Alpha Blade as a meaty to like bait reversals, you know, and to catch your back dash. But I have to use meter to combo from it and to get like additional pressure from it. What this does is that it sounds like you could combo from horizontal alpha now without meter. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, and this means that you could probably do like 5H counter hit routes exactly where P alpha picks up and you get 2K. TK P alpha, yeah, in the corner. I keep experimenting with TK P alpha, but it's so hard. It was so hard and inconsistent throughout the cast. You have to confirm it with a different button and you have to do it at the lowest possible height. And it didn't work with everybody and it only works sometimes. Now this is making it better. So this might mean meterless conversions. I actually don't know. Because they gave you meterless conversions from K-Alpha, but I don't know. Either way, this is a buff. This is a buff. This means that certain combos you couldn't do before are now possible. Pretty cool. But the crazy buff is this one. Reduced attack startup on Senshu. These motherfuckers said 20 frames isn't fast enough. Bro, they literally said 20 frames is not fast enough. Not fast enough. We want to make him like as fast as Leo when he Rekka 3s. So you know what? They reduced the attack startup. Now it's going to be Leo level, bro. That's fucking crazy. That's crazy, bro. Not to mention, the reduced startup for Senshu means it could combo from Rokosai on crouching hit. Crazy. Rakosai being Rekka 2. Yeah, and no more trades with 5 frames. Good point, Searchlight. I don't know if it's 1 frame faster, 2 frames faster, but it's faster. That's a buff. Alpha Blade horizontal, meaning you could do some additional conversions. That's pretty good. How much that makes a difference, I don't know. 6H, opponent will now be in a crouching state on grounded hit. I don't know, that's kind of weird, right? It's actually crazy because if you could combo from Rakosai on crouching hit, does that mean, bro, does that mean off of regular far slash Rekka, if I notice you're crouching, if I notice you're crouching from far slash Rekka, do I get Senshu after every time into pressure? Do you know what I'm saying? I could easily hit him from that. I could just say far slash Rekka. Oh shit, he's crouching. I get fucking Senshu every time I notice they're crouching. That's fucking crazy. That's crazy. That's a gigantic buff. Let alone. Wow. That's okay. How this is gonna translate is I don't know, but he got nothing but good things. And other characters got nerfed in some capacity. He did not get nerfed in any capacity. This is all buffs. They just gave him more shit. Okay? That's fucking nuts. Senshu? Okay. Good luck blocking it. A lot of people struggle blocking it. Chip is 2 thumbs up. It's over for everyone. I'm winning Evo now. Let's go. Frosties? I'm gonna win Frosties, bitch. My boy Chip is carrying me now. We did it, boys. All right, Potemkin. The additional range for his pokes, such as far, standing S, and standing HS, improve his mid-range game. Expanded frontal hitbox. They don't talk about hurtbox. You know what I'm saying? That's his hitbox right now. That's pathetic. That's kind of pathetic. You know? The hitbox being further out is probably good. Additional range. Expanded frontal hitbox. That might be good. God knows what's going to happen. Standing HS. Oof. Damn, that shit is hella disjointed. Jesus Christ. That shit goes even further now? That's really strong. Expanded frontal hitbox. That means it hits even further. That means that you could, like, literally zone a lot longer with him, probably. If those buttons just hit that much further, that's really good. Sweep, reduce recovery. Okay. What's the recovery on sweep right now? This is good for fucking the boy here. Okay, 21 frames of recovery. That's crazy. Now you could just throw that shit out. Look at that shit. That's a good button. You're gonna be able to control neutral a little bit more. A boy and Turb eating a little bit with these first few changes. These are good changes. Heat Knuckle now draws the opponent in on Guard Crush. Huh. How did Heat Knuckle work with that before? Oh, yeah. Okay. That means you could if you hit Heat Knuckle, you don't have to walk forward anymore. If you actually get him to block that, it's a force 50-50. Right? Vacuum Heat Knuckle. That's pretty cool. That's pretty cool. That means that you literally pull him close to you and you force a mix-up if you land Heat Knuckle. I like that change. It's good change. Good change for Potemkin. Now I could no longer, like, just get the fuck out for free. Because now, like, if you hit Heat Knuckle, I could just always fuzzy jump. Maybe. You never know. You never know what this means. Because now I could fuzzy jump for free. You know? So who knows how close you get? Who knows, like, if it's plus now? I don't know. But being drawing the opponent in, I think that's good. Vacuum effect on Heat Knuckle, that's pretty good. Decreased tension balance, increased negative value. What does that mean? Now decreases tension balance. What does this mean? Pop players, you guys are smart. What does this mean? You can't... Oh! Back Mega Fist gives negative penalty. Oh, that's a good. That's good for me. Now you guys can't fucking spam that shit against me. Okay. Sped up the timing when Potemkin can withstand attacks. That's a good change, right? Hammerfall being buffed is good. What's FDB? Oh, flick. Reduce attack startup. That's really good. I think that's good. I wonder how that translates into your block strings. Flick is universally catches jump. That's probably a good change. Huge change for him. At close range. Ah, yeah, you see, exactly. At close range, the faster startup for FDB makes it harder for your opponent to escape by jumping, meaning his core throw mix-up is more potent. You guys are happy about that, huh? Now y'all could fucking FDB, bro. Okay, let's move to Faust. Increased startup or increased knockback on standing H allows Faust to create distance from the opponent, meaning he could use what could this be more. Oh shit, increased knockback on those moves? That's fucking ass. Well, I don't think that matters against Chip. Chip could just run and far slash him no matter how far he fucking pushes me away. The reduced startup for mix makes it easier to use in combos while also making it harder for the opponent to interrupt when in block string. Decreased attack startup. Reduced lower hitbox on the Scarecrow. Yeah, so you know, he got some reduced upper hurtbox. What the fuck? Crouching P was already like impossible to hit him. Reducing the upper hurtbox might make it harder for me to hit him with a 6H, which is the only way that I get in. Sped up timing of input buffer window. These are all pretty good changes for Faust. I don't know what it's going to translate to, but pretty good changes for him. Yeah, low profiles, Soul 2D, crazy. Increased attack level of tandem top makes it less risky for Milia to use in string and in neutral. That's good. Reduced recovery of 6... Is that her 6K? Wow. I wonder what this translates to. Standing heavy slash now bounces opponent higher. Decreased horizontal blowback. Decreased attack startup on 6H. Reduced recovery. Oh, no. Uh-oh, that means I can't DP that anymore. Her 2K 2D is going to be fucking more annoying now. Frame advantage and distance after a successful throw is now the same against all characters. She's eating, bro. Milia can now move to the other side of the opponent even when they are in the corner. Reduce hurtbox behind Milia. What the fuck? Oh, no. Oh, fuck. Okay, so Milia definitely got buffed, bros. All over. Fuck. I already don't like fighting her as Chip. This is going to be a little bit more annoying now that she could force RPS with Turbo Fall even in the corner. That's a huge buff. Huge buff for Milia, in my opinion. Because now, like, now she could do her 2K 2D disc, Turbo Fall, and that shit's like, a you know, safe to DPs. Cross up in the corner. That's fucking nasty. Okay, Zotto. Ability to move only Zotto and or Eddie during Break the Law. Opens up new possibilities for strings. Okay, so basically Zotto is more annoying. This just means that Zotto could be more annoying in certain aspects. Reduce hurtbox on activation of Sun Void. Makes it more difficult for the opponents to interrupt it when used in block strings. That's pretty good for him. 6K reduced recovery and decreased knockback. Okay. Jump D, sped up the timing when Zotto pauses before the attack is active. That means that the JD glitch that all the Zottos complain about might be fixed. Breaking the Law, only Eddie will move now when you use that input. Eddie will no longer move with that input. Increase forward movement speed. Tension gauge now decreases. Okay. Can't spam it. Sun Void, okay. Reduce for all hurtbox. These are all buffs for him. He got some good changes. Very minor overall, but I think the JD being fixed, it was gonna be the huge buff. She got nasty buffed. Minor buff. Okay, Ram, additional range of Crouching H. Let's look at Crouching H. Oh, that one. Expanded frontal hitbox. Makes it easier to go into highly damaging combos, making her more threatening at close range. Yeah, they're gonna be spamming that move now. JD now works better as a jump-in due to the addition of a hitbox behind Ram. Aralumo was a potent offensive tool for many situations. The damage and situation on hit have been reworked. That's great, that's her fucking Rekka. Yeah, this is like whenever you saw a clip of Ram just like literally doing Rekka, getting a counter hit off of Rekka and then one-shotting you. Yeah, that's gone. That's a huge nerf for her. You know how many times I lost to fucking Rekka, bro? How many times I fucking lost to getting counter hit Rekka'd by Ren? Fucking bullshit ass fucking move. Erlumo third hit, all versions. The opponent can now recover after landing. What does this mean? Does she not get a combo anymore? Without meter or something? That's huge. I don't know what that means, but that's a gigantic nerf, if so. So she got minor nerfs. But I think the system changes are not gonna favor her. They're gonna favor other characters. You know what I'm saying? The system changes hurt Ram more than a lot of characters, in my opinion. Because now, like, her corner pressure is not gonna be like as potent. And if you manage to escape, you're in a good position to, you know, do a little bit better. Especially with damage being reduced. I think overall she got minor nerfed. Still playable. They didn't gut her completely, but she's still playable. Leo, adjustments to knockback and blowback for 6k and the increased range for Ersti's Gestauber make them more viable in combos and forming strong block strings. Okay, so 6k, decrease knockback, decrease. This makes it so that it's easier to IB, so that's a potential nerf at the same time, though a buff in combos. So I don't know this. How does this? I don't understand why this says that it's like a buff. Make them more viable in combos and forming strong block strings. This sounds like a nerf. This being expanded frontal hurtbox and hitbox and hurtbox on this sounds like a nerf. Certain hurtboxes, expanded hurtbox. This is nerf. 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 Sweep is a buff. Sweep launching the opponent higher on hit gives Leo more of an advantage, making it easier for him to go into Okizami. Oh, fuck. So, sweep is better. But whatever, if he got nerfed in other ways, I'm fine with that. So, whatever. Okay, here's the good one. You guys ready for this now? Holy fuck, bro. Holy fuck, dudes. Yes. I had to maximize this shit for everybody. Bros. Nago's defense now varies with the current amount of blood gauge. The damage and attack properties of his normal moves still increase higher as blood gauge gets, but he now takes heavier damage from the opponent, meaning he needs to consider any risks he takes in neutral. Hallelujah! Can we get an amen? Give me an amen. Amen. Fuck yeah. Fuck this character. Let's fucking go. Oh my god. This is a health nerf. Gigantic health nerf. This means that if he's level 2 blood and I hit his ass, he's gonna take way more fucking damage. That's crazy. So Nago got nerfed. Crouching S increased recovery as an exceptionally powerful poke. This was well deserved, bro. This was fucking nuts. This crouching S was like the best normal I've ever seen in any fighting game. If that makes sense. I've never fucking seen a button as good as crouching S for Nago. It's actually not fair. Like, I don't know what the fuck they were thinking. It makes the matchup so much easier. Chip might even win this matchup now. Nago's hated Chip before. It's over. It is fucking over for Nago, bro. It is over. 2S whiff? Oh, I could fucking whiff punish? Are you fucking kidding me? Fuck out of here, bro. Oh, he's level 2 blood. I hit him? Oh, I could kill him now. I don't have to hit him like a fucking million times. Wow. Alt nerfs. Good. This is fucking excellent. Excellent changes to him. Now reduces tension balance and now increases negative value. Yeah, back Fukio could create a negative penalty. Fucking great. Reduce lower hitbox. Wow. Reduced recovery on far standing S, final follow-up hit. Okay, I guess that's fair. That's like the one buff he got, but it's like irrelevant. Reduced lower hitbox, that's a nerf. Okay, Geo, crouching HS now draws the opponent in, creating major changes in her combo. Using it with Sol Poente can lead to higher reward than before. That's excellent change. She has now access to more powerful combos in the corner due to her new wall bounce effect on standing HS. Sending HS now bounces the opponent higher with decreased horizontal blowback. Added wall bounce effect. Okay, crouching HS. Using it with Sol Poente. She gets better combos. More combos. Good changes. Frame advantage and distance after a successful throw. That's good. That's a buff. Buff. Lowered hurtbox. Okay, to be Sol Poente is the flip, right? Yeah, okay. They buffed this move. This move is garbage right now. This move is garbage, bro. So they made it better. Reduce lower hurtbox. Okay. Now less likely to end up behind the opponent. I mean, that's not really a huge buff. But the first hit now launches the opponent higher with decreased horizontal blowback. That's like when you do it in the air. Or maybe... So she, honestly, with just this... All this reads is that I think she just has better... She just has better combos. Better combos. And, you know, that's about it. Right? I don't think she got, like, crazy changes. She just has better combos, and now Sol Poente has better uses. Her combos are going to be nasty, though, potentially. Maybe her damage is going to be insane. You know? I don't know. Overall, I feel like she's probably going to be about the same. Maybe better. Maybe a rework on the routing. Yeah, her combo routes are going to be better. Yeah, 2H vacuum is weird. Yeah, I don't really know how this is going to translate to. But it doesn't seem game-breaking. So this is, like, definitely buffed. But is it going to fix her real problems? I don't know. It's, I guess we'll just wait and see with Geo. But I think these changes are good. And they're more fun. And they're fun. These are fun changes. Fun changes. Better combos are always good. Okay, Anji. Anji is looking... Let's look at Anji. So standing HS now launches the opponent on grounded hit. Where is it? 5H. Okay, this one. Okay. Okay, so 5HS now launches the opponent on grounded hit. Making it possible to combo from Fujin into Rin. What the fuck is Rin? God, I don't know any of this man's moves. What the fuck is Rin? Oh, there you go. Oh, yeah, that one. That's the overhead. Okay. Oh, so if you hit 5HS, you get Fujin into Rin. Okay, cool. That's kind of like Chip. He kind of has, like, Rekka... Like, how Chip gets Far Slash into Rekka 1 into Rekka 3. Now, Anji gets that. Which is pretty good. Okay, so he not only has access to better combo routes, but also better situations for him. What's Iso Kutobi? Oh, that move. Oh, that's so cool. So you could do Rin, and then the overhead, and then you could get Okizemi using Iso Kutobi. Nagiha gives more of an advantage now due to the blowback adjustment, making it easier for him to maintain his offense. Huge. Huge change. Okay. Fujin changes. Nagiha. Yeah, these are all good changes. Excellent changes. Okay, so then Ino. Okay, she can now jump cancel the beginning of her hover dash. This allows her to move a greater distance forward than with standard jump. So she could now jump cancel the beginning of her hover dash. That's really, really good. This allows her to move a greater distance forward than with a standard jump. That's really good. That's really good for Ino in, like, matchups like Happy Chaos, where she was just kind of, like, fucked. Ino was fucked in some matchups, man, that she just couldn't move. Being able to jump cancel the hover dash is huge. Combined with the reduction to Sultry Performance's landing recovery, she has now a greater arsenal of approach options from midair. That's fucking great for her. Great for Ino. That might be a KOF hop. Maybe, bro. Dash startup can now be jump cancel. Sped up timing when Ino can block. That's great. The timing is now the same as when canceling the startup of a jumping attack with Faultless Defense. Fixed a bug where it was possible to Psych Burst. Air dash. Added proximity requirement for the attack to connect. Expanded attack hitbox on hit or block. Stroke the big tree. Reduce hurtbox before movement begins. Okay, sped up timing. Motion could be interrupted. Added proximity requirement for the attack to connect. That's a buff for her. Reduced hurtbox before movement begins. Stroke of the big tree. Reduced hurtbox before movement begins. Upper hurtbox of this steadily decreases as the move comes out. This change reduces the hurtbox. Reduced landing recovery. All of these are buffs for her. But they're not like insanely broken buffs. Do you know what I'm saying? These are like quality... Thank you, bro. Thank you. These are like quality of life buffs. All of these are really good. This lets her move a little easier against matchups that were like almost impossible for her before, like Happy Chaos. She couldn't actually beat Happy Chaos. I don't know how the fuck any, you know, could do it. Now she has tools that could fucking help her out, which is excellent. Expanded the hitbox of JH behind Gold Lewis. Makes it easier to connect after jumping over the opponent. This makes his pressure from close range even more potent. Wow, they just buffed JH? What the fuck? It was already kind of degenerate, no? Unless I'm thinking of JD. Oh, okay. Oh, they increased it? Yeah, I guess that's cool. That's fine. It already kind of hit behind. But I guess it's now even easier. Thunderbird now disappears when he takes damage, making it challenging to launch an aggressive approach. Gigantic nerf. Gigantic nerf for Gold Lewis. That's fucking nuts. Huge. This makes the matchup with Pot like actually doable. Oh, the cross-up was 6P OS-able. Now it should not be. Okay. Thunderbird is being nerfed is very bad for Gold Lewis players. Pour one out for the Gold Lewis homies. I mean, to be fair, Thunderbird was OP, bro. Yeah, no more mindless running, bro. Yeah, because that shit... Thunderbird is just really, really good for a lot of characters. Standing K, it added stagger effect on counter hit. That's good for him. That's a buff. JHS, that's a buff. Thunderbird nerf. The hit effect of the final hit now varies depending on the security level. I don't know what that means. Burn it down, increase number of hits. That means that this... That's also potentially buffed. I don't know. He got a nerf. He got like a major nerf. But it's not going to be like... Stupid. He's still going to be fine. Yeah, I think it's going to be less random carried GI players for sure. Okay, Jacko. Servants fly higher and farther when hit with crouching S. This makes it not only viable as a starting point for her offense, but also in powerful strings, making use of the time difference. Okay. Which is her crouching S? Oh, yeah, that one. Huh. Okay. I don't really see them use that move a lot. So that's going to be... there's going to be some new tech for Jacko. The changes to countdown's launch makes it easier for Jacko to go into combo after blocking the explosion. Okay. Crouching S. Reduce frontal hurtbox after your attack. That's a buff. Minor buff. Minor buff. Minor buff. Added wall bounce effect. Okay, that's a buff. Will now register input when the button is held as well. Countdown. Adjusted launch, increasing time when the follow-up attacks are possible. Yeah, so this is all minor stuff. It's hard to say, like, you know. It's hard to say how good it is. Happy Chaos, guys. Here we go. JD now draws the opponent in, making it easier to lead into an advantageous position for him in close range. Okay. Let's see what JD is. Okay, that one. Okay. All right. I mean, that's fair. That's fine. It's not really like... You know, the good Happy Chaos players used it properly anyway, so it wasn't like... crazy. So, as... 6k could be easily included in combos from any situation and was extremely powerful in maintaining offense on block. The attack startup has been increased. This is really strong. This is really good. This means we could potentially 6p the gaps. Okay, so 6k being nerfed, I don't know. You know, I don't know how much this is going to nerf Happy Chaos, but it looks like it's going to fuck up his combos. Because, you know, like, they like to do the gunshot into 6k, into another gunshot, or whatever the fuck they do. We could even look at a match of Umisho and see like how many 6Ks he did, which I'll do after this to see like how big of a nerf it's going to be. Because it seems like this is a critical part of the of his block strings and his combo structure. And it being nerfed could just be kind of what, you know, would actually make him a little bit more fair in some ways. You know? 6K might, you know, right now it's throw punishable, but you have to be like, you have to mash throw. It being slower means that you might have more reactable counterplay for 6K. I don't know. It no longer hits consecutively after crouching K, which is after 2K, you can't go into 6K. That's fucking really good. That means that you're forced to go into 2D now from 2K, which means that, and 2D could be punished, which is good. So that's great. That's a nerf. So nerfed, now launches the opponent higher. That's an, I think 6S is potentially a nerf. Or a buff? What does that mean? Now it launches the opponent higher. Is that a buff? I don't know his combo structures that well, but it launching the opponent higher is either a buff or a nerf. I don't know. No more slump. Hmm. Oh, yeah, that's true. True. Yeah, you're actually right. No. I mean, if 6K is nerfed, I mean, I don't know. Some of his strings might not be the same anymore. I don't know. It's hard to say. A lot of this stuff is kind of ambiguous. But he could be overall worse. He did get some nerfs. Not a lot of nerfs. Not as much as he deserved. Now Curse reduces tension balance. That's good. Scapegoat reduces tension balance. Increases negative value. Cancel aim, reduce recovery when activated. That's a buff. The fuck? Why did they give him that? When activated with no concentration. Now draws. He didn't really get. I mean. He barely got fucking touched, bro. He barely got touched. Though, I don't know. It could be worse. 6K, I have to consult Umisho, bro. This doesn't. He didn't get hit as hard as Nago did. That's for sure. That's, yeah. I don't know. We're gonna have to see, like, how badly his combos are adjusted now. And, like, how much scaling he has now because of, you know, the new overall changes. His damage might be significantly lower. You know what I'm saying? Maybe the damage being lower is just gonna fuck him up a lot more, you know? I don't know. We'll see. At the very least now, like, because Chip's Rekka 3 is faster, if I do get in Unhappy Chaos, I'm gonna be able to hit him a lot harder. Which is good. Yeah, everything is looking like minor balance changes. Bayan is more of a threat at close range now, like she already was. This is fucking ridiculous. As she can more easily follow up on cross-up Yo Johnson mix-up. I mean, that's, I guess, a fair change. She could already follow up on cross-up Yo Johnson. Now it's more consistent. Because sometimes she would do cross-up Yo Johnson, and then she couldn't get the 2S follow-up. You know what I'm saying? By expanding the hitbox of the explosion part of Kenju, that's the gun, it now functions better as a poke and in combos. Kenju is the gun, right? Yeah, that's the gun. That's crazy, because it already had an insane hitbox. Insane hitbox. Okay, so decreased horizontal blowback distance of the later half of the active frames. Hmm. Does this mean that, like, if you block it, you could throw her more consistently now? You know what I'm saying? I don't know. I don't even know what removed usage restriction means. On Tatami Gaichi. She didn't get really changed at all. This is like, they literally didn't do shit to Baigen. She's the same. This is like very minor. Everything is minor. They kept her, I mean, I guess that's fair, but they kept her basically like in the same spot. Didn't you have to wait for a Tommy mat to be gone before you did another one? You're probably right. Is that what that is? That means you could just be like fucking tatami gaish like over and over and over again.
Okay.
That gives her better neutral control. That's a buff. Testament. Can now Grave Reaper can now be used back to back, greatly improving Testament's control over neutral. That could be huge for Testament. This is buff. Crouching Age draws the opponent in. Opening up new uses is in combos and in block strings. That's a buff. Nostrova increased active frames of the first and second hit. That makes it more consistent when you follow it up. Testament, it got buffed. Testament, Grave Reaper. Greatly improving Testament's control over neutral. I mean, all of these are buffs for Testament. Testament is already really strong. So Grave Reaper usage restriction. That means you could just keep throwing Grave Reapers. That's really good. You could just keep throwing fireballs. You could play like Ryu fucking fireball game, dude. And just fucking 6P the fuck out of everybody that jumps at you. Especially with the universal changes to 6P. I don't know what the fuck. This is good. Draws the opponent in with Crouching H. That's really good. Reduced launch. This is all good. But minor. These are minor changes. But yeah, the Grave Reaper being able to rapid fire that shit. Very good. Oh my god. Okay. Holy shit. Okay. Bridget is... I knew it, bros. Bridget kind of went under the radar this patch. Bridget was already kind of good. Okay. Bridget was like... Her kit was good. But like Bridget just didn't do enough damage. That was kind of like how I felt about her this patch. So Bridget has more opportunities to launch her offense from neutral due to the increased projectile speed and reduced recovery for stop and dash. Okay. Damn, stop and dash. That's the skates. That's good for her. She has more potent options available after rolling movement connects as it changes to the knockback and trajectory create less distance with the opponent and leave Bridget more at an advantage. Wow. Okay. Expanded lower hitbox and hurtbox for crouching P. 6P causes blowback on hit. Expanded lower hitbox and hurtbox. Wow. Okay, so a lot of adjustments are normals. Stop and dash, increased damage. That's good. She needed more damage. Increased movement speed of a projectile. Increased proximity requirement for the attack to connect. Okay. Reduced recovery. Damn, on stop and dash. That means that she could just be like, you know, she could skate and then stop. Skate and stop. Skate and stop. Reduce recovery on that? That's pretty fucking good. Rolling movements. All versions. Decreased knockback. Increased descent speed. When activated as the yo-yo returns to Bridget, she now moves towards where the yo-yo is placed. That's really strong. That's a fix. All of these are really good fixes for Bridget. The universal scaling is really going to matter. This character may do even less damage. Well... The good part is that they did say increased damage on stop and dash. So maybe in some ways, but they gave her, everything I'm reading is a buff. And she was already kind of going under the radar a little bit. Expanded upper hitbox. Increased number of hits. This, I don't know what this means, but this means that it, this might mean that, the damage was increased as a result. Break, kickstart, expanded upper hitbox. Yeah, added tumble effect. Wow, combos are better. She's buffed completely. She's buffed completely. Bridget is gonna be OD. Nothing to him. Nothing to Sin. Sin is kind of trash right now. I'm gonna keep it a buck, guys. I think he's mid tier at best. Sin, as cool as he is, I feel like he's mid tier. You could play him if you want, but you're going to be struggle city with Sin, bro, in a lot of matchups. You fight a chip, it's game over for you. So yeah, overall, pretty good changes. Pretty good changes, huh? Pretty fucking good changes, right, guys? Fuck yeah. And I don't know what this means yet, but... Being that it launches the opponents higher, that means that I probably get a combo in a lot of situations I normally didn't. So overall, Pot got some really, really good buffs. I don't know how much they're gonna translate, but these are all excellent buffs. I mean, he needed something, right? So he got a list of all positive changes for him. Chip got all positive changes. Axel positive changes. May got buffed, bro. May's gonna be disgusting now. Kai got some changes, but not crazy. This being nerfed is interesting. I guess they don't want people dying off of one fucking hit. Mochi has to stop fucking murdering people. All right. So those are all the changes.